How do you expect it to be, yaar? It's just pulling on. I'm just pulling on, waiting for shoot to start. Been trying out new things.
It has tested your patience. I mean, matlab acche se patience test ki hai sabki.
I think starting mein, yaar. Abhi I think I've gotten so used to it ki ab thodi anxiousness hai. I'm not my patience is not being tested right now, but I'm just a little anxious and a little. क्या बोलते हैं वो डर बैठा हुआ है कि मैं जब शूट शुरू होगा मैं वापस एक्टिंग कर पाऊंगा कि नहीं, जब लाइट्स कैमरा बुला जाएगा तो मैं अपना डायलॉग भूल जाऊंगा कि नहीं, तो अभी वो सिनेरियो है.
सो मेरे साथ सेम हुआ, मेरे साथ सेम हुआ ये चीज. कल मैं ऑडिशंस दे रही थी एंड आई एम लाइक डूड, मेरे को लग रहा है मैं एक्टिंग भूल गई हूं.
कुछ तो गड़बड़ है, क्योंकि हमने ना ये छुट्टी को ना बहुत लाइटली ले लिया, मुझे ऐसा लगा. तो मुझे जब मिला, जब एक एक वेग मैसेज आया था कि वी माइट बिगिन शूटिंग वेरी सून, तब मेरी फट चुकी थी भाई. तब मैं जाके पुराने स्क्रिप्ट्स निकाल रहा हूँ, मोनोलॉग्स ट्राई कर रहा हूँ, हर एक डायलॉग को डिफरेंट वे से बोलने की कोशिश कर रहा हूँ कि याद रह जाए बस. और मैं जब एक्शन बोला गया तो अपनी यू नो आई कैन इमोट माय डायलॉग्स, आई एम जस्ट वेरी वेरी स्कैर्ड राइट नाउ.
कल तो मेरी मॉम ने मुझे पॉइंट आउट कर दिया है कि तुम सच में एक्टर बनने जा रही हो. मैंने कहा हाँ मम्मा. तो इट्स दैट बैड. सो नाउ आई सॉ यू सिंगिंग यस्टरडे, सो व्हाट अ न्यू थिंग.
व्हाट अ
आई सॉ यू सिंगिंग यस्टरडे.
या
सो इज दिस समथिंग न्यू और व्हाट.
आई यू नो आई डोंट नो हाउ ट्रू दिस इज. ओके, आई वाज नॉट अ ग्रेट सिंगर. आई स्टिल डोंट कॉल माय सेल्फ अ ग्रेट सिंगर और एनीथिंग. क्या हो जाता है ना, कभी कभी ऐसे लगता है कि भगवान आके साक्षात बैठ जाती है इधर, तो संग संग रिकॉर्ड कर लो और पोस्ट कर लो. एंड आई थिंक दिस इज ऑल्सो विद सर्टेन एक्टर्स. आई बिलीव यू नो आई थिंक अ लॉट ऑफ एक्टर्स दे आई थिंक दे कैन जस्ट सिंग, बिकॉज हम इतने जो वॉइस मॉड्यूलेशन प्रैक्टिस करते हैं और इतने जो डायलॉग्स के जो पिच को हाई लो करते आई थिंक वी टेंड टू जस्ट एंड मानसी साथ थ्रोइंग अ वॉइस वी टेंड टू जस्ट सिंग. सलमान खान सिंगिंग तो वैसा, अगर फैन फॉलोइंग हो जाए ना मेरा कि मैं कुछ भी गा दूं, कैसे भी गा दूं, मैं हिट हो जाऊंगा, तो वो शायद यस
हो ही जाएगा. वो
तो शायद यस पैसा पैंपरिंग हो जाता है कि मैं कुछ भी गाऊं, हगू भी तो लगे, ओ हो क्या हगा है, ऐसा होना चाहिए ना.
हो जाएगा आई एम प्रीटी श्योर तुम्हारे साथ तो हो ही जाएगा. मैं
होपफुली यार
सो आई स्टार्ट विद माय क्वेश्चंस नाउ.
ओके
एंड द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज दैट आई ऑलवेज वांटेड टू आस्क यू.
ओके
सो इट इज लाइक I'm very curious, you know, to know this, that you have this personality, your dressing sense, your rings, your tattoos. Where does this come from, like? What's the reason behind it?
I think my first ever inspiration would be Judy from Kasauti Zindagi.
Oh.
Purana Kasauti.
Oh, okay.
So, Karanveer Bohra played that character, right?
Yeah.
He went, and I think I was really young that time. I was in my fifth or sixth standard, and you know, mama used to watch it. So, घर पे तो यही है ना कि अगर मम्मा देख रही है तो फिर हम भी बैठ के देखेंगे. So, I remember when he used to go Mother India, and he used to raise his hand and he used to talk. I think I really liked that personality also, and you know, the fact that I think बचपन में यही instill हो गया था मेरे दिमाग में कि the fact that not all those boys who look like those badass people are actually bad by heart, because he was a very nice character, he was a very nice guy by heart. Karanveer Bohra in the show UD was a very nice guy by heart, and I really like that, you know, ki I can look badass but at the same time have a very 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 clean heart, right?
It is true.
Yeah, so that is where my accessories ka you know, वो चुल शुरू हुआ. Tattoos, it's to believe it or not, I will not lie. Tattoos the only reason why I got myself a tattoo was because मैंने Pinterest पे एक quote पढ़ा था. I swear to God, I'm not making this up. ऐसा कुछ नहीं है कि वो cool बनना था या कुछ. I swear to God, मेरा tattoo का only and only reason was because I read this quote on Pinterest, which said, if there's anything that you will take with you to the grave, it's your tattoo.
That's true. That's deep.
Because it is your skin right now, right? The tattoo is my skin ka hissa. So I'm gonna be going with nothing apart from my own skin, right?
Exactly.
And my tattoo is my skin. So that's true. Wow. I'm like, wow. That actually makes sense.
Yeah.
And then there's another quote where people said, there was a quote that said, everybody loves art. Some people like to hang it on the walls, and some people wear them.
But the first one is like, first quote to mujhe bhi hit kar gayi hai.
Haan yaar, fact hai. I was actually surprised because back then, before I got my tattoo done, I was dating this girl and she was tatted completely. She had a back tattoo, she had a tattoo on her arms, her elbows, her thigh, her calf, everywhere she was tattooed. Though it looks nice to look at, but I was never a fan of tattoos.
Okay.
And she also never tried to convince me to like it. She's like, this is a part of me and this is who I am. So I was like, okay. And then I saw that quote, and when I saw that quote, I was like, wow, ab to mujhe tattoo karana hai.
What was the first tattoo?
This is my first tattoo.
Oh.
So this is a it has the drama faces, the masquerade, jo hum log ke actors log ke jo face hote. It has that.
And
it has a sad face in front, and it has a hourglass at the sides, and then it has a happy face at the back. So it says basically after every sad phase in your life, you get to be happy too. तो हर चीज का एक फेज होता है एंड इफ देयर इज अ सैड फेज यू विल आल्सो गो थ्रू हैप्पी फेजेस. गिव मी अ मिनट. आई थिंक द सन शाइनिंग टू ब्राइट ऑन मी. जस्ट गिव मी अ मिनट.
ओके, नो प्रॉब्लम.
बेटर. यस.
सो या एवरी टैटू मींस समथिंग.
या ऑब्वियसली आई मेड श्योर आई डिड नॉट गेट एनी टैटू इन एनी हेस्ट. मैंने बहुत से टैटू, I have three tattoos and all three tattoos के ऊपर I spent days together keep thinking कि because अब now when it's gonna be stuck to my skin,
yeah,
it just can't be anything, right? It has to be something I believe in. I believe in the fact that every life has its ups and downs. Every हर शाम के बाद सुबह होती है and that if you're sad you're gonna be happy. So I got that first. The next tattoo I got again after a breakup was, which made me realize that which is this one, which people tend to really like. It is
that's my favorite one.
Yeah, a lot of people like this. So this stands for strength, experience, and hope. So the firm tree stands for strength. The murjhaya or jhar stands for experience because it has been through all seasons.
Oh.
And the bird stands for hope.
Wow.
So I thought that through also. Yes, I have experienced it all, and I am strong. And I will not give up. And I always have hope of doing better. So I
that
really
reminds
good
me.
Thoughts to it. Yeah, I bedta hu 2-3 days, 4 days, hafte bhar, and I think what I want. And I find it very stupid if people are just getting whatever tattoo just for the sake of it. Aap tattoo laga de rahe ho, and I think it's like they say your body is a temple, so you should really worship it. And if you wanna give something to it, make sure you believe in that.
I agree. Like, I want to get a tattoo, but till now I haven't got anything. Like, which is like, जिसको मैं सुबह देख के अपनी स्किन पे देख सकूँ. अभी तक मुझे कुछ ऐसा मिला नहीं. They are get something like that.
हाँ, which is good. That is how it should be. Tattoos are not. आप अभी जैसे आप अगर बोलो कि you write down a quote and you don't believe in that quote. You just wrote it down because you feel it's cool. That doesn't make you someone who loves art or someone who loves tattoos, who loves the ideas of tattoos.
I
think every tattoo should have a very deep meaning to it. If not a deep meaning, at least something that you believe in.
So you just said that you're very strong. that reminds me of the talk where you told me about your initial days in Bombay.
Right.
Your PG days and initial days.
Yeah.
So, would you like to tell something about it, or maybe the failures you faced, which entirely changed the thing? Like, whenever you face a failure, either you give up or you get up.
Right? Yeah.
It's the turning point. So, tell me, share me something about like your initial days in Bombay. Because I know a bit about it, but not in detail.
Okay, so it all started when I was in Calcutta, and everybody, and I auditioned for a show, and Calcutta se main audition kiya, mera pehla show ka audition tha, and the makers of the show really liked my audition, and they said we want you, aur sab finalized ho gaya tha, and they said look test ke liye ek baar sab shave karo, and when I shaved and cut my hair, they realized that I do not look 28 at all, right?
Okay.
So wo show mere haath se chala gaya. तो मैं सोचा यार अगर मैं कलकत्ता बैठे बैठे अगर एक इतना अच्छा ऑडिशन क्रैक कर सकता हूं आई थिंक आई शुड गो टू बॉम्बे एंड ऑल सो देयर वाज दिस फ्रेंड ऑफ माइन फ्रॉम माय ग्रुप ओनली कलकत्ता के ग्रुप पे हम साथ जाते थे स्कूल हम साथ लंचेस करते थे हम साथ आउटिंग्स पे जाते थे वी वर इन द सेम ग्रुप राइट एंड ही वाज इन बॉम्बे सो आई कॉल्ड हिम अप आई सेड यार देख ये सिचुएशन है क्या करूं He's like, हाँ हाँ आजा आजा मैं हूँ ना don't worry आजा मेरे साथ रह ले ये होगा रेंट का ये होगा ये होगा मैं बोला okay fair enough and I actually had nobody in Bombay ना तो ले ठीक है fair enough तो I came to Bombay he gave me the address and when I reached the address it was of a PG and I was like wait hold on let me just confirm if this is I said, I called him, I said, bhai, ye PG hai. Bula, haan, main tujhe ek do minute mein call karta, main thoda busy hoon. I said, okay. And I thought I'll just check the place out, right? Aur maine dekha tha, to this is the room that I was staying in, it was supposed to be ek room mein there were 6 bunker beds. That's 12 people living in one room with one fan on top and no ACs. And sab bunker pe na, ek, sab bed pe ek chota sa fan attached tha.
Okay.
So, और सब में ना मच्छरदानी लगे हुए थे एंड मैं ना थोड़ा वो हो गया यार कि मैं इधर कैसे रहूंगा यार आई मीन दो आई हैव बीन इन अ बोर्डिंग स्कूल एंड आई हैव स्पेंट हाफ ऑफ माय टाइम इन बंकर बेड्स बट दैट वाज वेरी डिफिकल्ट आई मीन व्हेन कसौ में तो बंकर बेड इट वाज एनीवे कोल्ड यार दार्जिलिंग इज अ कोल्ड प्लेस यार बॉम्बे की गर्मी में मैं 12 लोगों के साथ कैसे रहूंगा एंड आई सॉ द बाथरूम आई वाज लाइक यार ये कैसे करूंगा यार मैं एंड There was no geyser, ठीक है, and मैं एक ऐसा बंदा हूँ, 50 degree Celsius होगा ना मैं तब भी गर्म पानी से नहाऊंगा।
Same, I'm also one of them.
तो अब मैं ये हालत देखा मैं बोला यार क्या करूँ? I had nowhere to go, so I called him again, said, you know, just help me out, what the hell is happening? तो उसने बोला यार जो है यही है, रुक जा मैं तुझसे बाद में आके मिलके बात करूँ, मैं busy हूँ, and he cut the call and he switched off his phone.
Oh shit.
And the owner of the PG was like, देखो भैया लेना है जल्दी लो एक ही बेड है बताओ क्या करना है मैं बोला रुक ही जाऊंगा थोड़ा स्टे अप 1-2 डेज एंड सी रीसेट नहीं आपको अगर पेमेंट करना है आपको 3 महीने का एक साथ करना है
ओह
सो लाइक यार ले ले आई थॉट 3 महीने यहां काट लेता हूं लेट मी सी सो आई रिमेंबर द दोज वर टफ टाइम्स यार आई मीन आई रिमेंबर आई मेड रियली कूल फ्रेंड्स देयर आई मेड वेरी गुड फ्रेंड्स देयर I actually made very, very, very good friends there, you know, because these people, they didn't really judge you for anything.
Yeah.
But haan, jaise sab jagah ek do teacher wale log nikalte hain, to the waise bhi. I remember one of these guys would tell me, yaar, main hoon na, usi jagah pe. I didn't have any audition groups or anything. So, I went on the road and randomly asked people, hey, actor, who is going to audition? Can you share some numbers with me?
Oh, you've done that.
Yes, I have stood outside Yash Raj, I've stood outside Balaji, I've stood outside this, what's that place? Aram Nagar. And I've just randomly asked people, share some numbers with me, give me jitne bhi aap production houses hai mere sath number share karo please and whatever and there was this one man who used to stay in a PG and he used to tell me that he's gonna get me my first work ठान के बैठ, मैं तुझे तेरा पहला काम लगे दूंगा. एंड आई बिलीव देम यू नो. एंड आई रिमेंबर एवरी डे टू मेक हिम हैव चाय एंड एवरी डे टू मेक हिम आलू पराठा. कुछ तो काम दे दे वो मेरे को. वो उसने जो मेरा काटा है ना भाई, he has taught me so much now, that man, उतना मेरा काटा है वो. He told me, तो मेरे को कॉल करता था, जल्दी जल्दी आ, जल्दी आ, मैं यहाँ पे बैठा हूँ, जॉन एब्राहम के यहाँ बैठा हूँ, आके तेरी बात कर, उसकी प्रोडक्शन में बात कर लेता. एंड आई शुड जस्ट गेट रेडी फास्ट, आई शुड रीच, मिनट आई वुड रीच लाइक 5 मिनट पहले निकला है, 5 मिनट पहले आ जाता ना, बात करा देता. चल ठीक है, आ ही गया तो चल एक आलू पराठा खिला दे, चाय पिला दे, कुछ खिला दे, ये हो गया था सीन. अब ये 1.5 महीना मेरे को वो खींच के, वो मेरे को रोज कुछ ना कुछ बोल के मेरे को मेरी बुरी तरह काटा था.
सो
सो दैट्स व्हाई आई लव दिस सिटी यार, हांडा. आई थिंक बिकॉज़ दिस सिटी टीचेस यू सो मच ना, इट टीचेस यू सो मच इन लाइफ, इट टीचेस यू हाउ टू सर्वाइव, इट टीचेस यू हाउ टू मीट assholes and how to deal with them, it teaches you how to give back good to people who've given good to you, and it's taught me not to ever give up, it has taught me to never give up. So I think
I remember
there was a rat that crawled on me, you know,
in PG.
Meri phatti hai rat se abhi phatti hai, but us time I don't know why, I maybe because I've gotten so used to it. I still can I show you the watch that I have?
Yeah, please.
Yeah, okay. So that, I keep that with me for the. I have always kept that with me. I'll show it to you.
Okay. So please.
Yeah. Sorry. Do you see this? This is my Armani watch. Okay. Before I came to Bombay.
Okay.
And look at this. This is chewed by the rats.
You still have it?
Yeah, I still have it. This is how I remember my roots. This is how I remember where I come from. And that I should never let fame or money forget what my real times were like. The watch doesn't work, but it just reminds me.
It reminds you. Okay. So, Mo, is there something that doesn't let you sleep, or there's something you are very uncomfortable talking about sometimes? I mean, any thought that, you know, while sleeping, it shakes you sometimes. There's something, sabki life mein kuch aisa hota hai, you don't want to think about it, but when you think, toh humari fat jaati hai, something like that. Is there something?
I feel, mujhe na ye dar hai, ki I will not make it as big as I want to be, you know, because for a fact, okay, whether it is Shah Rukh Khan, whether it is, let's take the biggest stars, okay, name them. You take Rajkumar Rao, you take Ayushman Khurana, you take the best stars, like the people whose acting we love. They have really put in a lot of effort, right?
Yeah.
And that is something I do not put. मैं नहीं करता हूँ रोज मोनोलॉग्स, मैं रोज एक्टिंग एक्सरसाइजेस नहीं करता हूँ, मैं रोज आई हैवंट एवर, आई हैव स्टिल नॉट इवन जॉइंड अ डांस एकेडमी टू लर्न डांसिंग, राइट? एंड आई नो आई एम नॉट पुटिंग इन इनफ एफर्ट, एंड आई नो दैट मेरे लाइफ में मुझे जितना कुछ मिला है ना, उस पर 60% इज बिकॉज ऑफ लक, 40% इज माई टैलेंट. दिस इज व्हाट आई बिलीव, कि आई हैव जस्ट प्रॉब्ली बीन very lucky to get whatever I've gotten. Obviously, I've hustled for it, but that hustle isn't
at
that level, right? Mujhe agar star banna hai, toh I have to do a lot more than what an average actor here in Bombay is doing.
So that
I think really scares me. I have really high goals. I've set really high goals for myself, and I want to achieve them. I really want to achieve.
So, don't you want to work on them now that you know it?
Yeah, that is what na, ye hai na ki main janta hu mere flaws kya hai, and main 2-3 din ho jata hu ready ki main dunga hi karunga hi karunga hi karunga, chauthe din fir baith jata hu.
That's human nature. Wo mere sath bhi kai cheezon mein hota
hai. Ha, so I think this, because of this, I'm a little scared.
But the fact that you know it, I guess, you know, sometimes people are not aware of it. sometimes they are big in their head and they think I'm bahut kar
raha. Yeah.
But the fact that you know
people
it.
People are ignorant. Yeah, I'm not ignorant yeah. about it.
Yeah, the fact that you know it, probably someday when you, someday or the other, maybe tomorrow,
haan,
maybe today.
You know, when I know that I've got a big role, when I know that I've got a big role and I have to work for it, maybe then.
You will start.
Because I'm doing TV. Huh?
You will start working on
yeah.
it.
I'm hoping. I swear. पर हो जाए यार मतलब कोई अच्छा रोल मिले तो मैं मेहनत करूं वैसे मतलब हाल ही में
did you work something for your web series for the web series never kiss your best friend
for never kiss your best friend I actually didn't do anything for the character yeah.
Okay.
मैंने सिर्फ because that character is he's just a badass right and there's nothing else about that guy and that you know he was gay and I understood the character. Okay, I sat down with the writer and I actually got the gist of the thing. So, the good part about that series and you know about shooting for that series is though I did not have much knowledge about the character, my director was ready to put in that you know that effort and he was ready to take in my you know my views about the character, right? So, when that happens, na Handa, I think I told you this also. When you work with a director who understands you, who wants to listen
yeah.
to your views, automatically they're acting at you.
Yeah. So you're a director's person.
I am a director's actor. मतलब director अगर मैंने कुछ चीज अपने दिमाग से सोच के बनाया, if the director says नहीं, ये नहीं, I want you to do this, I will do what he wants me to do. तो मैं वो एक बार में I am totally a director's actor. While shooting with Never Kiss Your Best Friend, I remember we did the scenes and everything was okay. He liked my takes, he liked my shots. Sab jitne shots aaye the acche aaye the. Then there was a point where I had to come out with the character that you know that Kabir is gay. I had to say that out. Yes, that I am gay and you know I'm fed up of listening to this. Okay. So in the script, according to the book, Kabir cries. He gets emotional,
okay.
He gets upset and he cries and he says, yeah, I am gay. And, you know, I'm just sad that my family is orthodox, so I have to do all this. But, you know, somehow I felt maybe he didn't need to cry. You know, the fact that Kabir is a badass, the fact that Kabir is making out with some other guy from the same party where his girlfriend already is.
Yeah.
He doesn't give a shit. मेरी बहन ने मुझे बोला इसको पटा के रख सर मुझे नहीं लगता कि कबीर को रोना चाहिए एंड ही सैट डाउन ही थॉट दिस थ्रू ही सेड कैन यू गिव मी अ टेक where you feel Kabir rona nahi chahiye but you know show me something where he has a little bit of regret I said
okay.
yes sir I will keep that because at the end I feel bad for doing that to this woman so when we went for the first take and it was shit cold okay? it was around minus 6 degrees and I was shirtless main kurte ke bina tha meri phati padi तो आई रिमेंबर व्हाइल डूइंग दैट सीन आल्सो बिकॉज़ इतनी ठंड होती है ना तो आपकी बैक वैक जकड़ जाती है एंड यू कांट स्टैंड स्ट्रेट
आई
डोंट नो हाउ नकुल भाई डज इट आई हैव नो आईडिया हाउ नकुल भाई डज इट ही इज अ बॉल ऑफ एनर्जी एंड ही डिड इट जितने बार बोलो वो रेडी था मेरे टाइम पे ना आफ्टर द थर्ड और फोर्थ शॉट एक ही शॉट का यू टेक 3-4 टेक्स एंड एवरीथिंग सो व्हेन वी आर डूइंग समवन एल्सस एंगल जब क्लोज अप शॉट्स लग रहे थे तो देयर वाज एन एडी हु लिटरली sat down and he was holding on to my back taki main giru nahi kyunki main itna jakad gaya tha na mera back and my back you know I have back issues right and I could not take the pain so he was there holding my back so I don't fall
and it doesn't look like
I don't know
he looks super comfortable while doing it
he had to make it look like that
yeah that's the job
main baat kar raha hu bol nikal rahi hai
I know the day you came back to India I went to London
Yes.
So I know.
Yes.
It was damn cold.
So coming back, finally the take that I gave, the first take that I gave, he said cut and he came and said, Mohit, this is it. this is what we want. We don't want you to cry. He called up the writer. He said, listen, I'm not making Kabir cry in this scene. Because abhi jo take mila na, if you see it, you'll fall in love. The writer said, fine, if this is what you feel. And the next day, he saw the take and he came and told me, bro, love the shot. Sumit was the writer.
Okay.
So he said, bro, love the shot. And I remember I did not, I just felt, you know, you should not cry. And even the director, when he saw that, he felt, haan yaar, rona nahi chahiye isko.
That's nice.
You got a great shot. You got a great shot. And you tend to even feel bad for Kabir in the end, if you see. Yaar, bichare ke saath galat hui hai.
Haan.
So, he passed that off for a great
shot. You don't, like, for a second, you feel like, if he's a gay, why is he doing this with a girl? But after, when he comes out, you're like, nahi, yeah. He understand why he's doing
it. Galti nahi hai, yaar. Laika hi kutti thi. So he that's what the director said, and he was like, yeah, I love this take, and I, you know, the fact that we feel bad for Kabir and that Kabir doesn't come across as the bad guy at the end, it's great.
Now that
we
I know now that I know your input for that scene and the story, it makes me, like, you know, fall in love with that scene, because that scene is very beautiful.
Yeah, that was the main scene, you know, and we had a, honestly, the director and I, we had a lot of, you know, he threw his version, I threw my version, and he was like, he more good transition aana chahiye, ki bad guy se suddenly banda ho diya. I said, sir, but, and my comeback to that was, sir, but wo to har movies mein hota hai na, ki haan, jo hard hai, wo suddenly soft ho gaya. Ye to bahut common, bahut cliche hai. Let's keep it hard only, but we give him that, just a little bit of, tad bit of touch of goodness in it. We'll not make him look like a good boy. We'll let him be the bad boy. We'll let him be the bad ass guy and with a tinge of goodness in him. He's like, yeah, fair enough.
Nice.
That's how that scene came out.
So, this one is my favorite question.
Okay.
Where does the humor of Mohit comes from, like?
Where does my humor come from? This, I wish I knew. I swear I don't know. Abhi, I really don't know. Main bol deta ki memes hain, because I see a lot of comedy shows and I love the comedy genre. But I don't think it's that, because main na starting se hi funny raha hu. From the time I remember, I've always been the funny guy of the class. I think it's just in the way
it's in the
those people, they watch the entire video.
Yes, and you are one of them whom I wanted to interview. Like, I had a few first names and you were in the first list, because when I was new to Bombay,
right.
I remember sitting with you and you used to tell me that how you like, no one can do anything for you in Bombay. You are the one who has to do something or the other. No one. Tum har raat ko party mein logon ko miloge, log tumhe promise kar rahe hain, agle subah unhein yaad bhi nahi hoga tum kaun.
Facts.
I remember you told me.
Facts. So, I've been through that.
Yeah, and I remember the very same night I saved your number as pep talk. And it's still the same. So, right now, you know, the things are going on where everyone is talking about mental health and everything. So, what's your take on it?
Yaar, you know, Hana, I'll be very honest. I just feel that everybody in this world should just be kind to everybody, you know, or just try and put a smile across at least one person's face for every day. At least one. Decide which person you want to put a smile on. Or roz kisi ek stranger ko pakad ke just make them smile. You know, it's not that difficult. If I walk on the road and I see somebody and I just say, hi, nice shirt, I think that's going to make him smile. It's very simple to be kind. It's very simple to be to make somebody smile, because you really don't know what somebody's going through. Earlier, So remember, there's this time when I put up a post about, you know, suicide and everything, and that, you know, do this, do that. And there were around 2-3 people who had something bad to write even on that.
Okay.
ठीक है? तो मैं ना थोड़ा, I got a little think, यार ये क्या है? यार certain posts where you feel कि it doesn't deserve anything negative. उस पे negativity क्यों आ रही है? And then Sushant's thing happened, and I realized that, you know, and I read also that he had started pushing people away, right? Mm-hmm. And then I spoke to people, and I realized that maybe even those haters that you get, those haters that I get, those haters that anybody in the world gets, jo haters, you never know, those haters have probably fought so much that now their defense mechanism is to just be rude to everybody. Maybe somebody has been bullied so much in his life that right now he hates people. Right? So, uske baad na, I actually felt bad, you know. And I make it a point ki mere jitne bhi, even then, pehle bhi main ye karta tha, because of, you know, not becoming a bad guy. But now I do it, now I reply to hate comments in a way, I always put humor in it, but I make sure that the person doesn't, you know, feel bad from inside, and I do not encourage the comments that come afterwards, because you don't know what that person is going through. Maybe that person actually commented just because he wanted my attention or she wanted my attention. Maybe because they're going through some tough times and they just want to be heard. You know, whether their opinion is right or wrong, it doesn't matter.
Right. It has given me a different angle towards, you know, the hate comments. I'll keep it in mind.
Yeah. So, koi koi cheez ke liye hate comments zaruri hai hi nahi. But usme jab aate na, so then that makes you think that maybe that person is going through something. And you know, I think the problem with India regarding this whole mental health thing is, ek to we don't want to talk about it. I'm not talking about the person who's going through it, because I've even understood that, you know, someone who's depressed or someone who's going through this major depression, they've tried everything. They've obviously tried coloring, they've tried whatever I mentioned in that post, you know. They've tried talking to people. Maybe they've given up on trying all those things so many times ki uske baad bhi usko happiness nahi mila na, then they tend to do something. My problem is, the biggest problem in India is, jab koi communicate करने की कोशिश करते हैं ना, that's when we go like, अरे यार, get over it, it's okay, ये कर, वो कर. What we don't realize is maybe the person does not want your opinion. When he wants to talk or she wants to talk, he or she just wants you to hear. Just sit down and listen. Be a good listener. Whatever the person has to say, you have an opinion about it, don't say it. Hear him out. Let him take that bhadas out. कुछ भी बोल रहा है, कुछ भी बोल रही है, सुनो. I think that's one problem, and the second biggest problem is, how do I say this? When we say na ki visit a psychiatrist, right? The first thing that goes in that person's head is, main pagal thodi hu ki main psychiatrist hu. And I think this, even our parents, even our elders, they need to know this, that when you go to a psychiatrist, doesn't mean you're mad.
Yeah.
दिमाग का डॉक्टर बोलते हैं एग्री, बट इसका मतलब ये नहीं कि तुम पागल, तुम सनकी हो. तो उसके लिए अलग ही डॉक्टर्स होते हैं. साइकियाट्रिस्ट इज समवन हु जस्ट हियर्स यू, हु लिसंस टू यू एंड अंडरस्टैंड्स यू एंड टेल्स यू थिंग्स दैट ही इज राइट. ही इज आल्सो स्टडीड अ लॉट टू गेट इनटू दैट प्रोफेशन
ऑब्वियसली,
राइट? एंड ही नोज व्हाट ही इज सेइंग. ही इज नॉट हियर टू टेल यू दैट यू आर मैड, और ही इज नॉट हियर टू गिव यू पिल्स. A psychiatrist, I've never been to one. I don't know if they give you pills or anything, but I think they tell you, they just hear you out and they tell you what to do, which will make you feel better.
Yeah.
So the biggest, this mindset of Indians have to change, ki a psychiatrist matlab pagalon ka doctor, main pagal thodi hu, main psychiatrist hu. So once these two things changes, I think it will be a better place. These two things, and if we start being kind to people, I think we'll be fighting it out really well.
I hope so it happens. I guess after what just happened, the tragedy with all of us, I guess people will take their mental health seriously now. I hope so.
Yeah, I hope. We can only hope this yaar Honda ki kya chalta hai logo ke dimag pe, you don't know what battle someone's fighting. I don't know, man. I mean, this, I think it works both ways. When a hater comments on our pictures, we should think maybe he's going through a tough time. But even then, a person should also think na, ki, it works vice versa also. You don't know what frame of mind I am in. Today, I'm a very jolly guy, kind of a guy. And I'm a very happy-go-lucky kind of a person. But aaj shayad mera mood off ho. Okay? Aaj shayad main kuch cheez ko lekar upset. I'm human. I'm supposed to get upset. I can get upset. I can be sad. And if somebody from comments mein kuch aur saddening bol deta, you never know which wire it triggers. Yeah. Right? So I think both ways people should tend to, you know, think before talking. It's... Well, then when you don't have anything nice to say, don't say anything at all.
Yeah.
If you can only stick to... Life is so simple. It is so freaking simple. Why do humans complicate it? I don't get it. It is so simple. If you have nothing nice to say, don't say anything. Walk out. Ignore. Tumko galat laga. Today people have been upset with Sushant's demise. And they've gone up and they've commented on Karan Johar's, on Alia Bhatt's, on Sonam Kapoor's and everybody, all the other star kids' pictures. Yaar, what do you mean by saying uske, you're taking a stand for Sushant in one hand by saying ki he was going through depression because of you guys. And on the other hand, you're saying uske wajah tujhe mar jana chahiye tha. How are you being the nice person? How are you taking stand for somebody that way? I feel that maybe there the other things must have happened that pushed him to do something of that sort. But you can't completely blame them. I don't think if Karan has a 50% blame to take, the other 50% blame should be taken by the audience. Why would Karan launch a star kid if the audience never wanted to watch a star kid? Because the audience wants to see the star kids. Tell me something. Why does Ananya Pandey have more followers than Vijay Verma?
That says all. That says everything.
Vijay Verma is a fantastic actor.
Because we want to follow him. We want to follow her and not follow him.
Yeah. Why is it that a film like Baagi 3 or Student of the Year 2 does better than a film like Angreji Medium or Hindi Medium? Why?
Because
we are watching.
So if
you're blaming them, blame yourself as well.
True that.
You want to watch new talents come up, but you don't want to support them by watching the film. How is that going to make any sense? Take the blame. If you're giving the blame, take the blame.
So that's your take on nepotism.
Yeah. That's my take on this whole mental thing also. When you're taking it out on somebody, make sure that, you know, that you are also putting that negative thing, thoughts in their head. You know, I don't know. None of us know what Karan Johar is going through right now, maybe. Maybe he's locked up in a room thinking, what the fuck did I do?
Yeah.
He must be thinking, yeah, I'm launching Star Kids because you guys give me the money for Star Kids.
Yeah.
Why? He must be thinking, what have I done wrong? He obviously must have done something wrong to definitely push Sushant to such a level. But you cannot give him the blame completely is all what I say. But yeah, that's my opinion. Once you post it, then I will be getting these hate comments. But I'm ready for it. Sab cheez ka ilaaj hai, ignorant log ka ilaaj nahi hai. So I can't do anything about it.
I agree. So let's just take it a little down. And being in the industry more, you really need a lot of time to yourself. Like you need a lot of self time. And especially for a person like you who has suddenly started growing so much, like after every few months, you're adding something or the other to your cap, right? How do you manage to be in a relationship that to a live-in relationship? I'm sorry, Steph, if you hear this, but I really want to know because I can't give this much time to someone in my life right now. Like, I can't afford. Thinking of it makes me like, yeah, meri space kahan kya, main kaise karungi? So how do you manage it?
I don't think have needle space from home. Yeah.
Okay.
I think it's about when you find the right person. I've been with a lot of women in my life, and I have been in relationships with a lot of women in my life, and it's just about finding the right person. Once you find the right person, I don't think you feel ki space chahiye mujhe jaane do. You have fights. You tend to have major fights. Okay. But I think you just become okay with it, and you want to sort that fight out. Your ego goes down. It's the love that comes up, and you know, I think the fact that in the same room, if Steph and I are in the same room, we are in the two corners of the bed, we might not talk to each other for 1 hour, and we are okay with it. But the minute Steph gets up and leaves the room, I would be a little angry. Steph, where are you? Come to the room. Or sit next to me. Don't talk to me. Just be around me. I think we've reached that zone right now. So
that's cute. That's
cute. I think it's about finding the right person. I'll be very honest.
Yeah.
I've been with a lot of women in my life, and with most of them I felt that this is final, I'll do this with this. But when it's not the person, it's not the person. And when it is, it is.
That also reminds me that you have a lot of female friends. Like, most of your best friends are females. And you, I've been around you, I've seen you. You respect women a lot. You don't hesitate appreciating them. You don't hesitate calling them boss, ladies, or something. So, is there a reason behind it, or is it, it's a story or something you've learned from your family? Because this is a very good quality.
I think this is instilled in me by my family.
Okay.
You know, because touch wood, my dad is madly in love with my mother. Right. They are legit goals. I have not seen them fight. Okay.
Oh.
I have not seen their fight. 26 years of my life. Okay. I have not seen any of their fight escalate for more than 5 minutes. You know, if dad is pissed, dad is yelling, and mom is like, "Tacha," and my dad just goes, "Haan, par Rani, tum samjho na." So I'm like, okay, what is that? Right. So. And my dad has always put this in my head, or in our heads, me and my sister, mama's been the lucky charm. And when ghar ki Lakshmi jab khush hoti hai, to ghar mein barkat rehta hai. He's taught me this, and he's always kept mama very happy and always made sure that she's smiling. So I think that is one reason why I am what I am towards women. And the other reason is, I think, yeah, women are going through a lot any which way in their lives, especially when we live in a country where they are catcalled every day. They are not respected. It is a sad, right? So I think you know, the fact that they go through so much in their life already, if by just one person, if I could put even, if I could, just make them smile once and, give them that hope ki nahi, not all men are screwed up. There are certain men like me, and not just me, there are a lot of men like me who will love you, who will respect you. I think the women deserve it. Yeah. You guys deserve it. That's the reason why I think, Handu, you deserve it.
Thank you. Okay, so is that a reason that you avoid PDA? In one of the interviews, you said that I don't believe in PDA and I don't do it.
No, PDA, I've never been a fan of from the start. Yeah. I don't know. Mujhe thoda ajeeb lagta hai. Before I even became a thing, when I was in Calcutta also, even then I didn't enjoy PDA. I don't know. Mujhe thoda awkward lagta hai. I don't want people to see me, what I do. I don't know, yeah.
That's a rare quality, you know.
I don't know. I mean, some women probably appreciate PDA and they want to be, they want their man to. So I tend to show off my woman a lot. Okay? I will grab my woman by her waist at the party. I will make sure that everybody knows that, yes, I am her man. and yes, I'm taken by her. But you can do that without having to do PDA. You know, without, I don't have to, you know, smooch her in front of people. I don't have to lick her in front of people to show that, you know, I'm taken. I can just hold her hand and, you know, hug her, or, you know, just make it obvious that by just holding her hand, you know, I think the action itself would show ki, yaar, these guys are madly in love. And
that is one of the reasons that we guys love enjoying, like, we enjoy being around you guys, because you are not that couple who are, like, into each other and making other people awkward. So that's also a reason that, you know, when we think about couples, if it's Mo and Steph, haan, ye chalega. Par yaar, baki ka, let's see. But Mo and Steph, haan, ye chalenge. Inke saath maza aata hai. Like, we can enjoy with them.
Yeah, because we know na ki ab hai, her friends are her friends. My friends are my friends. Now, her friends and my friends are together. They are friends now. So, we know that, okay, we spend so much time with each other. We don't have to be stuck with each other now. Let's just give our time to the friends who come home. We follow that.
I hear it. So, well, I remember when I messaged you saying that, you know, the engagement on our accounts is really going low, and we should, you know, comment on each other posts and everything. And you told me, Hanu, don't get into it. Like, you should not get into it. And I realized it later. And then later on, that post which said TikTokers, roadies, and Splitsvilla people are not celebrities. And with the thing of this new thing where everyone wants to be an influencer.
Right.
Like, I don't call myself an influencer, to be very honest. I don't call myself influencer because I'm doing nothing to influence people right now. So what's your take on this? Like I know it, but I want you to tell.
The reason why I told you this is because I've been a victim of this myself. Okay. When Splitsvilla happened and I was gaining followers and I had so many likes and achieved likes, very good engagement. Phir next year ke Splitsvilla contestant tha. You guys.
Me.
Tum log ke likes badh gaye, mere kam ho gaye. So that time I used to be very, very sad, very upset. Yaar, ye kya ho raha hai, kya ho gaya, why is my followers dropping? And I was actually affected, okay? And I genuinely felt bad. And I remember I used to be...
Just a second. Yeah, now you speak. Something is wrong with
it. Yeah, I used to be thinking about it a lot. It really started bothering me. It really started eating me up. Till I reached a point where I realized, fuck, no. I did not come to Bombay to have a certain number of followers. I did not come to Bombay to be an influencer. I came to Bombay to be an actor. I'm supposed to be acting well. I'm not supposed to be clicking good pictures. I'm not supposed to be posting well. I'm not supposed to be garnering likes well. I'm supposed to be acting well. That's my only job. Likes, kuch bhi. I'd done everything. I tried maintaining a feed. I tried theme rakha maine, different
editing
app download kiya. I was like, yaar, nahi hua. Nahi hua. Screw it. I'm just gonna post whatever the I want. Okay.
I've started doing that.
Yeah. Because this is, why do we forget that this is our Instagram feed? We will post what we want to post. I want, when I go back, when I'm in my 60s or 70s, if I go through my Instagram folder, I should look at these pictures and have a memory and laugh about it. Right? So I'll post what I want. I will, if I have to add humor, I will. If I want to post a good picture of myself, I will. If I want to post a funny picture, if I do not want to post for a Father's Day, I will not. My job was to get up, call up my dad, Papa, happy Father's Day. Call up my Chacha, call him and say, Chachu, happy Father's Day. Call up my brother, tell him, now you're a dad, bro, happy Father's Day. That was my job, I did my job. I don't feel like I should put up any story, I don't feel like I should put up any post. I will not. These are things that are going to eat you up. And that is the reason why I told you don't get into all this. And
I realized that at the time.
हाँ और रहा बात जो टिकटॉकर्स वाली बात पे यार, ट्रेंड चल रहा था ठीक है, एंड दिस प्लाकार्ड ट्रेंड वाज गोइंग ऑन एंड आई थिंक इट्स अ गुड ट्रेंड ओके एंड अगेन लाइक आई सेड इट्स माय इंस्टाग्राम फीड आई विल पोस्ट व्हाट आई वांट टू पोस्ट एंड आई फेल्ट दिस इज फनी एज फक
इट वाज हिलेरियस
आई एम अ कंटेस्टेंट ऑफ स्प्लिट्सविला मायसेल्फ एंड आई डू नॉट I'm a celebrity. And I posted that. Funny बात ये है कि जो जो अपने आप को celebrity समझते हैं, उनकी जली। जो नहीं समझते, वो नहीं, जिनकी नहीं जली।
उन्होंने support किया। जो जो
समझते, उनकी जली। So I was first very happy thing about it till I received one of these TikTokers told me that you have our fans are telling us that they are demotivated now. Our fans are upset, they are hurt, and because of you, so many people are hurt today. That's when I felt bad, you know. That's when I felt shit. It was a humor, my post was supposed to be funny. It wasn't to look down anybody. But have I really affected people that they have hurt people? Tab main rakhe na ek wo sorry wali post.
I remember, I posted it.
Usme bhi jab aake jo shuru kiye na, haters, wohi TikTokers wale. Then I came out to my real self and I'm like, you know what? Screw you. You do not deserve it. I wanted to take that post down, but then I realized, nahi, this is for those fans of his or those people who actually want to be on TikTok and want to get famous that way. I didn't want them to feel demotivated or something, so I told them sorry. But to those TikTokers who had a problem after I put that up, for them I gave it off. And believe me, I can't take the name, but there was some really renowned and very known TikTokers who've done big work. They talking like that seemed stupid to me. And till this day, if I ever meet them again, I'm gonna tell them this. You were stupid. You were very, very stupid. In a very, very, very normal tone, I'd make them understand. You're very stupid. You've done bigger work. What do you wanna be known as? A TikToker or an actor? The minute the person says TikToker, I will walk out. I'll rest my case.
Okay, fine. So my last question would be, what do you want to be remembered as?
Someone who put a smile on my face. Somebody who, I just want to be known as somebody who, who knows how to put a smile on someone's face.
So you've already...
Whether an actor.
In that case, you've already
done that. That's how I want to remember. मतलब अगर खुदा ना खासा कुछ होते and when like how people start sharing memes and not memes when people meme pages start sharing talking about you and all of a sudden when people have good things to say after you die, that time I want people to say that yeah this guy put a smile on my face and he was a very generous soul and mostly that he put a smile on my face.
You've already done that job.
Yeah.
We remember you that.
I want to be remembered as that.
Like if I talk about you, I'm like, "Wo to bahut funny yaar, mujhe sath bada maza aata hai, wo to bahut funny hai." I say that.
That's how I want to be remembered. I don't want to be remembered as the best actor Bollywood has ever seen, as the most handsome man the world has seen. No, I don't want to be remembered as that. I just want to be remembered as someone who made you smile, who made you feel good, who made you feel precious. That's it.
That's nice. So anything you want to ask me, like any question or something you want to feel like?
Yeah, I want to ask you what? Because I had really thought this through. Once you asked so many questions, I would ask what? Forgot what that question was. Anyways, Ray, I'll ask you this only. And what is your take on this whole nepotism shit? And the ignorant people. Ignorant people in your life? And was
now you say I wasn't able to hear. Something's wrong. Just a second.
Can you hear me now?
Now I can. No, I can't.
What is your take on ignorant people? You know, वो लोग जिसको तुम जितना भी समझा दे नहीं समझेगी. What's your take on that?
Yeah, my take is that, you know, you put in your efforts. You try explaining them. तुम किसी हद तक उनको समझाते हो समझाते हो. Then you realize that इनको नहीं समझ आने वाला. No matter what. They won't understand. Okay? And you believe in certain things as a, you know, as a friend or maybe as a person who has followers on Instagram or as a actor or stuff. किसी को भी ले लो. Then you try to send a message through whatever you are saying, okay? And even if अगर कोई तुम्हारा friend भी होता है, उसको आप 20 बार भी 100 बार ही समझा दोगे, but उसको नहीं समझना ही नहीं है, it starts creating negativity.
And then you tend to get more things.
You get fucked up in your head. So you leave it then.
You feel that there is a lot of ignorant people when it comes. Do you feel that there are a lot of ignorant people when it comes to this whole nepotism shit that is happening right now?
There are. A lot. They're just saying things without thinking. They're just saying because, haan, hai kuch kehne ko. I believe, even that day, I posted, I got affected about Sushant. Like, main bahut roi hu and for 3 days, I was not, you know, stable. And I literally had to delete my Instagram because it was so much of negativity around. I literally had to delete it so
true.
And so I literally posted that stop posting, and especially for people who have a good amount of followers, especially those people posting up fake WhatsApp messages, putting fake stories that iski wajah se uski death hui. A person has gone, let him go. Pray for his family, pray for him, learn something out of it. That's it. Stop giving your reasons. Who are you to like?
Sad, you know. I also find it very, you know, very weird how people have started following Sushant on Instagram after his demise. That is so stupid of you.
Yeah.
That is very, very stupid of you. It makes no sense.
Yeah, it doesn't. And it's sad, but I don't know, like, I hope people get the point at some time of their life that, you know, you just can't be crazy about something and just post it for the sake of posting it, or just say it for the sake of saying it until you mean it and until you have your logics behind it. Like the other day, I posted this thing where it said that people who want war, world war, just to tell you that you know, NDA ke forms nikal chuke hain, CDS ke August mein nikal rahe hain. So one of the person is saying that, you know, itna time lagta hai training ke liye, China wale war ke liye itna thoda wait karenge. So mera matlab usse ye tha ki it's very easy to sit at your home in a comfort zone and say ki haan, war hona chahiye. The people who will actually fight it are the ones who are there in the army.
Not just that. But that person, you need to tell that person that when a war actually happens, you will not be sitting at home either. Matlab, when a war happens, it's a very, very, very tough time for the country. You go through economic losses. You will not have food to eat. You will not have proper water reaching you. It'll be a dead place. You'll have curfews throughout.
Yeah.
People need to understand. Oh God.
So this is what it is.
घर बैठे-बैठे वो सिर्फ गाना गाएंगे, feeling proud Indian, but करेंगे कुछ नहीं. This is the problem.
Mo, it was really nice talking to you.
It was fun talking to you, Andu.
And I thought it'll go to 40 to 45 minutes, but we have literally talked for an hour and I really enjoyed it. And it has given me a confidence. It has given me a confidence because honestly, I was very nervous to start this podcast. But now I'm confident. I can talk to people whom I don't know as well. So, yeah. Thank you so much for, you know, agreeing and coming.
I hope I remain the best guy you've ever had in the podcast session. I hope you don't get somebody better than me.
You will, and more
in
than
case
that,
you I do, let me know because I'll see that podcast and I'll better myself.
cool. And I'll remember what you have taught me. Basically, I am doing this because I want to learn a lot about things. And, you know, sometimes talking to people make you realize certain things which books and internet right. and things can't.
Right.
So that's my main reason to start this podcast.
I hope and I wish you all the best with this, man.
Thank you so much.
Please get me into the habit of reading.
Give me good books.
Yeah.
We'll talk about it. No problem. Okay. Thank you so much, Mom. Bye-bye. Love you. Bye-bye.